Are you ready?
Hit it.
What'd you have in mind?
15 seconds to say goodbye.
Well, that's all.
Can you do that?
Just
yes. Say goodbye, Ed.
G-O-O-D-B-Y.
And you?
Good night, Gracie.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Hi.
Join us next time, Match 1077. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production. From Hollywood, it's the Newlywed Game! And here are today's newlyweds. This couple exchanged their vows 3 months ago, Carol and Joel Gardner. Our next couple tied the knot 23 months ago, Brooke and Ray O'Neill. This couple walked down the aisle 12 months ago, Danielle and George Hazelhurst. And our final couple traded rings 13 months ago, Shantae and Tahan King. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Newlywed Game. We're so glad you could join us today. I want you to say hi to my couples. Are you ready to play our game?
Yeah!
Good! Well, you've come to the right place. Got a great second honeymoon for one of you. First of all, we must send the ladies off to our soundproof room. Ladies, if you would, please. And gentlemen, in round one, we'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Hey, and remember, if her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And also remember that every correct prediction brings you that much closer to that fabulous second honeymoon. So the ladies are gone, and here's your first question. Tell me, gentlemen, which of the following sounds will your wife say she involuntarily makes most often in the middle of the night? Does she gasp, groan, giggle, or gurgle? Tahan, does she gasp, groan, giggle, or gurgle in the middle of the night?
Gasp, Bob.
She gasps.
Yeah, she's, because I'm always touching her. Things like that, like, leave me alone, you know.
Oh, she's going, leave me alone stuff. Yeah. Okay, Ray?
She makes a groan, Bob.
She groans.
She
in the middle
wiggles
of the night.
And moves, and I guess she just catches herself wrong and,
Okay. Joel?
She gasps.
She what, sir?
She gasps.
She gabs.
Yeah.
That's not one of them.
Gasps.
Oh, she gasps.
Yeah,
oh.
She gasps.
It's okay with me if she gabs, though. She gasps then, all right.
Yeah.
George?
She's a groaner.
She's a groaner.
Because when I'm getting ready for work, she's groaning.
Okay. Next question, gentlemen. How much money's worth of food will your wife say she gobbles up per day? Ray, how much money's worth of food does she gobble up per day?
Oh, maybe 20 bucks worth. She don't eat much. She has... She don't eat much. She just
Yeah, but $20 a day. Man, that's $600 a month. Holy cow. Joel?
I say about $10. About $10 a day.
$10 a day she gobbles up.
Yeah, she gobbles about $10 Ooh, a day.
George.
She doesn't eat that
she
much.
She gobbles up $5 a day.
Bob. $5 a day. Oh, you got off easy. Tahan?
About $2. She never eats. I come home, she has a headache. I'm like, why haven't you eaten? She says nothing in there, but she doesn't like to look in the refrigerator. So.
Oh, I see. So $2 a day. Man, you found yourself a cheap date, didn't you?
Yeah.
All right, last of our five-point questions. Gentlemen, if your wife could choose an implant for you, what type of implant will she say she would choose? Joel, if she could choose one for you, what type would she choose?
An emotional implant. I have to say an emotional implant.
Right, an emotional. So she's going to put it right there?
Yeah, right there in my heart.
Right by your old heart.
Heart
implant. Okay,
yeah.
Good. George?
Implant on my stomach, Bob.
Looks to me like you don't need an implant. Tahan?
Probably implant on my stomach to stop me from eating.
An implant in your stomach. Ray?
Yeah.
Probably a hair implant because I'm developing a bald spot in the back
of my
head.
A hair implant. All right, gentlemen, thank you. We'll be right back to reunite these newlyweds. And we'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Darkness falls upon your streets to possess your eyes with tricks and treats.
If you could only feel what I'm feeling.
Costumed MCs.
Then
famous names.
I'm Vincent Price.
Fill y'all's TVs and haunt your games. No one can resist the wills to watch these Halloween chills and thrills. Start Saturday at 4, only on Boozer.
To the Newlywed Game. Gentlemen, we recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. And the one couple with the most points at the end of the show wins that fabulous second honeymoon. I don't know if anybody's going to win. We don't have any points yet. Gosh. So, ladies, which of the following sounds would you say you involuntarily make most often in the middle of the night? Do you gurgle, gasp, groan, or giggle? Danielle, which ones do you make?
I groan.
You groan?
Yeah, he gives me a hard time about it.
He does.
I'm always moving around.
All right, he predicted you would say that you definitely are a groaner. Woo! Yeah. Hey, Carol. Carol, do you gurgle, gasp, groan, or giggle?
I'll say I groan.
You groan?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Joel, you know what Joel said? I was amazed. First he said you gabbed, but no, then he said you gasped. You gasp.
What do you mean,
y'all was talking about you hot.
How does she sound, Joel, when she does this?
Oh.
It's hot.
That's in the middle of the night, huh?
Yeah, in the middle of the night.
Huh.
I have hot flashes.
Of course you do.
What are you doing?
No, I don't have hot flashes.
Well,
he be dreaming.
He's dreaming?
Yeah.
What do you think, Brooke?
I'm going to say gurgle.
You gurgle.
I think I gurgle.
Congratulations. All right. He predicted that you are definitely, you're a groaner, he said.
Honey, you groan. You lay there, you turn over, you catch yourself just like this. Mmm. You groan.
Shante.
I'm going to say I giggle because when I'm tired, I get a little silly.
So you giggle at your husband? All right. He said that you definitely, you gasp.
Yeah, you know you gasp when I'm always touching and feeling. You like, gosh. You know, you know that.
Next question, ladies. How much money's worth of food do you gobble up per day? You personally. How much money's worth of food, Carol, do you gobble up a day?
God, that's a good one.
Thank you. I wrote this one myself.
Okay, I'm going to say maybe $10.
$10 worth. He said per day you gobble up $10. Yeah. Brooke.
I'm going to say, I don't eat much, so I'll say a dollar.
A dollar's worth.
Yeah.
He said, nah, he said, you're a fat one. $20.
I was thinking of my lunch.
$20 a day.
Because all I'll eat is like noodles and spaghetti.
Yeah, well, he
That's
said
like
you eat all the time.
I was thinking of my spending.
Well, it was my lunch, not yours.
I was embarrassed when
That's
he said
insulting.
It. I mean, it was insulting.
Yeah.
I was embarrassed, honestly. I said, you shouldn't say that about
Gosh.
Your wife. He said, why not?
Yeah. Long ride home.
Shante.
I'll say $20 a day.
$20. He said, you gobble up $2 a day.
You know you never eat. You know you never
me
eat.
All the time and I'm waiting.
No, but you know you never eat. When I come home, you have a headache. You're always about to pass out when it's time to clean up.
Brooke, what did you say?
I said, we need to switch. Her husband knows.
No, 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 no. That's the wrong kind of show. Danielle?
I'm going to go with $10.
$10.
Yes.
He said you gobble up a total of $5 a day.
I give her a $5 allowance every day before I go
Wait,
to work.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
She gives me an allowance. I ask, I say,
Time out.
She gets a
you give her an allowance?
Yes. No, he's not.
If she's not good, she gets $2.
Oh, please. That is so untrue.
May I suggest that you give him an allowance at night?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. You found it.
Next question, ladies. If you could choose an implant for your husband, what type of implant would you choose? Brooke, if you could choose an implant for him, what type of implant would you choose?
I would say...
Hurry, please.
A brain.
A brain implant. isn't love grand? Ray said you would implant some hair for him.
That's close, babe.
That's
but,
true.
Yeah. Shante, what kind of implant do you think you ought to give him?
I have to say.
Hurry, please.
Muscles?
A muscle implant. All right. He predicted you'd say that he needs a stomach implant.
No,
right,
I need
there,
a stomach
that's
implant
what I'm talking about.
Wrong muscle. Danielle.
I'm going to go with the stomach implant also because his stomach's kind of, he's real muscular everywhere else.
But he's got a pooch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Too much beer.
Yeah, too much beer. All right. He said he definitely needs a stomach implant. Yeah. Hey, Carol. What kind of implant does Joel need?
Could I say one or two?
Just give me one, please.
Oh, God.
What do you think?
Okay. You sure I can't give you two?
No, you can't give me two. Just give me one.
What about, okay, his stomach.
Stomach, all right. He said that he needs a heart implant.
You always say I'm not passionate enough, and I ain't, you know.
What passion got to do with an implant?
You said I ain't got no heart. You said I ain't
passionate
enough.
I would have said your feet. The feet.
Does she says you don't have any passion?
She said, I'm not affectionate enough, Bob. So I just said, I ain't got no heart. I need a heart implant.
You need more than a heart implant right now.
I was curious what the other implant. No, I'm the not feet. Even going to ask that. We'll be right back with the wives to see how well they predict what their husbands will say right after these messages. Welcome back, everybody. All right, ladies, your husbands are now secluded off stage. It's your turn to predict what they will say. And remember, these are the 10-point questions. Ladies, listen carefully now. If we put your husbands into a room with four different costumes, there's one of each one, and we let them fight it out to decide who wears what, will your husband say he would come back dressed as a caveman, a superhero, a cop, or Little Bo Peep? Now, there's only one of each costume. They're going to have to fight it out, okay? So, Brooke, Ray's going to come back dressed as a caveman, a superhero, a cop, or a Little Bo Peep.
I'd say definitely a cop.
A cop?
Yeah, he was in the Marine Corps, so he kind of likes the uniform thing.
That's cool. And Carol?
I'll say a superhero.
He'd come back dressed as a superhero.
Yeah, because he like Batman. He's stationed like 430 for Batman.
All right. Good. Danielle?
I say a cop. He always wanted to be a cop when he was a kid.
Cop, so yeah. Boy, they're going to be a heck of a fight in there for that one, isn't it? Shantae.
I'll say definitely a cop.
He's going to become dressed like a cop.
Yes, definitely.
Nobody picked Little Bo Peep. Next question, ladies. If you went camping and shared a tent with another couple, will your husband say he would or would not be willing to get romantic when the other two fell asleep? Danielle?
Oh, absolutely. We've done it many times.
Really?
Yeah.
In a tent?
Yeah.
With another couple there?
Like probably a month ago, actually. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. On the beach, in the tent, wherever.
And another couple was sleeping there.
Well, not really with us, but kind of in the next tent, you know. But if you're
I don't know.
They can hear. Yeah.
Wow. Shantae, you're in this tent with another couple. They go to sleep. Would he be willing or will he not be willing to get romantic?
He will not be willing.
He would not be willing
at
to
all.
Do that.
Uh-uh. No.
He's shy.
Good. Yeah.
Brooke?
He would.
He
Definitely
would?
He would, yeah.
No kidding.
Yeah.
How about Mr. Romance, Carol?
I don't think he would because he says I moan too much. So, no, I don't think he would.
Oh, okay. He would not. All right. 25-point bonus question. Ladies, what will your husband say was the name of the last magazine he read? Shantae?
VW Volkswagen.
The VW Volkswagen magazine. Okay, Brooke?
Four-wheel drive.
Four-wheel drive. Carol?
Oh, God, that's a good one because I really don't know the name of it because it has all of the different kind of rims for your car, and it's,
What are we going to call it?
Hot Rod.
Hot Rod. Danielle.
Ring. Ring Magazine for boxing.
Ring. All right.
Boxing.
Thank you, ladies. We'll be back with the husbands to compare actions on a new one day right after these messages. Back to the newlywed game. Well, I tell you what, we're going to see how well the wives have predicted what their husbands will say. And I'll remind everybody that these questions will now be worth 10 points. And a couple of you need some points here. Now, hey, before the break, we ask our wives, if we put your husband into a room with four different costumes and we let them fight it out to decide who wears what, will your husband come back dressed as a caveman, a superhero, a cop, or Little Bo Peep? Well, let's see how well they predicted. So we'll start with you, Carol. Carol, top card, you predicted your husband would come back dressed as what? Top card? As a superhero. Well, let's find out. Joel, come out here if you would, please.
Oh, no.
Let's see. I came back as a caveman. You can go sit down next to your wife now.
Okay,
you can throw that card.
Okay, man.
Superhero Batman.
Don't forget.
You love Batman.
He had to fight it out, though.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Okay, Brooke, what did you say? You said your husband would come back as a cop, All right, Ray, come out here. Let's see what Ray comes out as. Ray is Little Bo Peep. It must have been a heck of a fight going on back there.
Okay,
yeah.
Why did you say Little Bo Peep?
Those poor sheep. Yeah. Can you imagine what people are thinking? They're just tuning in. Look at there, Martha. They're playing. Oh, what the hell is that? Shante, you said your husband would come back dressed as, let me see, as a cop. Well, let's find out. Tahan, come out here if you would, please. A superhero! Congratulations, sir. Go over there. Well, Danielle, where are you going?
Oh.
You were trying to sit next to Little Bo Peep, weren't you? Yeah. You guys became pretty friendly back there. Well, Danielle, well, guess what your husband's going to be? Let's see what you predicted. You predicted a cop, and he obviously is. Get out of here, George. A cop. All right. Sit down. Go over there. Don't come near me. Look at Joel. Joel, I can tell you where you don't need the implant. next question now. That's funny. I like that. Yeah, we should do that again sometime. Yeah. And Bo Peep. Gentlemen, if you went camping and shared a tent with another couple, if you can find another couple the way you guys look, would you say that you would or would not be willing to get romantic when the other couple, when the other two fell asleep? Tahan, you're camping, you're sharing a tent with another couple. Would you be willing or not be willing to get romantic when they fell asleep?
I'll be willing, Bob.
You'd be willing, all right. She said, definitely, Tahan, you would not be willing. No. You don't have any points at all, you guys.
I know, man.
I know. Sitting there looking like Superman with no points.
Yes.
Okay. Well, George? George, suck your stomach in. Thank you. Would you or would you not be willing to get romantic when the other two fell asleep?
I would be willing, Bob.
You'd be willing, Bob. All right.
She
predicted
too.
He would say that card for me, please. Yeah, he would. All right. Joel. Joel, you look funny, man. Joel, would you or would you not be willing to get romantic?
I would not.
You would not. All right. Your wife predicted definitely that you would not. Okay. Yeah. How's it feel to have that much hair on your head again?
It feels kind of strange.
I can imagine.
It looks strange.
Here's a little Bo Peep and a mustache. Actually, he looks rather pretty, doesn't he? Yeah. Better leave me alone, Bo. All right, Ray, would you or would you not be willing?
I would be willing.
You would be willing? She said, yeah, he would. All right. Okay, before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Kramer.
It's a fabulous Caribbean cruise. You'll spend 1 week aboard a Costa cruise ship. Europe's leading cruise line. Visit such ports as St. Thomas, Grand Cayman, Ocho Rios, and Costa's private island. Experience cruising Italian style from Costa Cruises. Back to you, Bob.
Hi, John, thank you very much. Before we get to our 25-point bonus question, I just want to say thanks to our husbands for being such good sports. You guys are really good sports. We appreciate you very much. I tell you what. It better have four wheels and a steering wheel for me to put on a Bo Peep outfit, I'll tell you. Gentlemen, for 25 points, what was the name of the last magazine you read? Name of the last magazine you read. Let's go to couple number four. Tawan and Shante, you have zero. 25 puts you into this zooms you into second place, Tahan.
Hot V-Dubs magazine.
What is it?
Hot V-Dubs magazine.
Hot V-Dubs. She said it was definitely the V-Dubs. Yeah. Okay. Couple number three, Ray and Brooke, you have 10. 25 gives you 35. Take over the lead with the correct answer, Bo.
Off-road magazine.
Off-road. She said the magazine was four-wheel drive magazine.
Yeah, same.
Yeah. Okay, off-road. Couple number two, Joel and Carol, you have 15. 25 gives you 40. If you get it right, you'll be in first place there, caveman.
Lowrider magazine.
Lowrider. She said it was Hot Rod magazine. Oh. No. Couple number one, George and Danielle with 30, 25 gives you 55. What's your answer, George?
Flex magazine.
Flex magazine. She said it was Ring magazine, but that's all right. You guys have 30 points. You are Newlywed Dream Grand Prize winners. Hey, congratulations to George and Danielle. Thanks to all of our couples, and especially thanks to you. I'm Bob Eubanks. Hey, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody. It's the Newlywed Game! And here are today's newlyweds. This couple exchanged rings 13 months ago, April and John Cha. Our next couple recited their vows 16 months ago, Lisa and Jeff Hurd. This couple joined together 10 months ago, Tammy and Louis Ciordia. And our final couple made it official 4 months ago, Grisana and Raymond Davis. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks!
Thank you! Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Newlywed Game.
Hey, we're going to have some fun today. You guys ready to play the game?
Yeah!
Then I want you to do this for me. Ladies, if you would, please get up and go off to our soundproof room. And gentlemen, in round one, I'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. And remember, too, if her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And also remember, it's the couple with the most points at the end of the show that wins that great second honeymoon. So the ladies are gone, and I've got a question for you. Gentlemen, we're going to talk in astronaut terms now. In astronaut terms, when it comes to making love, what will your wife say is the one thing you're much better at than she is? The ignition? The blast-off? The orbit or the reentry? Raymond? Would that be the ignition, the blast off, the orbit, or the reentry? What are you better at than she is?
I would have to say the blast off.
Blast off!
Yeah, because I get it cracking right away. Bam!
And bam!
It's on.
Yeah.
There it is.
Gotcha.
There it is.
Houston, we have a problem. Jeff?
The reentry.
Okay.
John. Yes, definitely.
I got this goal with the reorbiting because when we hit that climax,
I don't have reorbit. I just have orbit.
Oh, orbit.
Just
I'm sorry.
The orbit.
When we hit that orbit, then we're
yeah,
really
I got you.
There.
Okay.
It's pretty
good.
Hot.
Louis.
Well, Bob, I'm gonna have to say.
Well, Bob.
Blast off.
Blast off. Next question, gentlemen. Where will your wife say is the most surprising place she has hair? Jeff.
She's a little bit on her back. Real fine. Real, real fine. Real fine.
She got hair on her back.
Real, real fine.
She drive a truck? Man, John.
Well, I'm going to have to go with her, like, bikini line. She's, like, she's always, like,
okay,
going
the old bikini
it,
line. Louis?
I'm going to have to say her legs.
She's got hair on her legs?
Yes.
Wow.
Well, she's always complaining about having, you know, too much hair on
yes.
her legs.
Yes, okay. And Raymond?
Probably her neck.
Got hair
I mean,
on her
just
neck.
A little extra, you know, a little behind the ear, kind of.
It's not the residual of a beard or anything, is it?
No.
Okay. Next question, gentlemen. As you notice, we have four boards with magic markers right there behind you. Now, here's what I want you to do. I want you to each turn and grab a hold of the magic marker, all right? I'm going to give you 20 seconds, and I want you to draw a picture of your wife with as many of her identifiable features as you can, so that she can recognize herself when she sees it. All right? Everybody understand how this goes? So I'm going to give you 20 seconds. Turn right now, on your mark, get set, and go. You want as many recognizable features as you can so that she will recognize this. Yeah. Watch old Raymond. He'll put hair in her neck. Yeah. There we go. Oh, yeah. There's no doubt that Walt Disney needs you guys bad. Good God, Raymond, what is that? Holy cow.
Okay, is time almost up? Okay, I think time is up, isn't it? All right, gentlemen, thank you very much. That's great. Now you can have a seat. All right. Man, Raymond, I don't know what yours is, but let's get off of it quick. We'll be right back to reunite the newlyweds. We'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Costumed MCs. Then famous names.
I'm Vincent Price.
Sell y'all's TVs and haunt your games. Halloween chills and thrills. Start Saturday at 4, only on Boozer.
To the Newlywed Game. Okay, gentlemen, we recorded your predictions on cards and now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. One couple with the most points at the end of the show wins a great second honeymoon. So if you're ready, ladies, glad to have you back. Tell me, in astronaut terms, when it comes to making love, what would you say is the one thing your husband is much better at than you are? Is it the orbit, the re-entry, the ignition, or the blast off? What is he better at than you, Tam?
He's definitely better at the blast-off.
The blast-off.
Yeah.
He said he is better at the blast-off. April.
I would also have to say the blast-off.
He's better at the blast-off.
Definitely.
He said for sure he's better at the orbit.
Oh.
Yeah, the orbit. Lisa.
The ignition?
The ignition.
Getting it started.
Okay. He said he's much better at the re-entry. Drisana.
I would have to say the blast off.
The blast off.
You
he said he's
it.
Better at. You ready?
Excuse me. I'm trying to get this.
Blast off. There you go. Okay. Next question, ladies. Tell me, where would you say is the most surprising place that you have hair? Most surprising place, April, you have hair.
My stomach.
I beg your pardon? You have hair on your stomach?
There's a little line of hair.
Really?
Your belly button. Oh.
Where is that from? I've never seen it.
It's just blonde.
John's never seen it. No, he said it's your bikini line.
Oh, everybody has hair there.
Lisa, the most surprising place that you have hair?
My upper lip, a little bit.
On your up, you know what he told us?
No.
I couldn't believe it when he said this. Let me see the card. Yeah. He said, you got hair on your back.
A little bit.
Yeah.
No, I don't. No, I don't.
Hey, if you had
some. She never sees your back.
Yeah, you can't see it. He can.
He's lying.
Risana.
I would have to say this area, my sideburns.
Your sideburns.
Yeah.
You know what? He told us. You got hair in your neck.
It's almost like the same. It's a connection.
A
little bit. Right.
This is not.
Raymond, it's not either. You said she's got hair on her neck. You didn't say anything about her sideburns.
Oh, my goodness. That's from my head. Oh,
Tammy.
There's no surprising places, but I guess I have toes on my toes.
Got hair on your toes.
On my big toe, I have hair on my knuckles.
You and Fred Flintstone. Yabba-dabba-doo. Louis said, you've got hair on your legs.
Duh. Not today.
Duh. All right, ladies, while you were gone, we asked your artistic husbands to draw their very best picture of you. Now, gentlemen, do not hold up the cards until I ask for them, okay? What I want, of the four portraits, which has captured the true you, do you think? Lisa, which one would it be that's captured the true you? A, B, C, or D?
A.
So you think that A.
I hope.
You think. All right. Let's go to Drisana. Drisana, which one do you think is you?
Can I hit him first and then answer? Because I know.
Well, which one is it?
B.
You think it's B? Okay, Tammy, which one is you?
It's a tough time seeing.
Well, you can just go out there and look if you want. Just walk right out there and take a good old peek. There we go.
It better not be D. I think he did.
You know,
B,
you're
though.
Awfully pretty for a lady with hair on her toes. So, well, you think it's what?
I think he did D.
D is your, okay. And April, which one do you think is yours?
I am so positive it's D.
You think it's D also?
I know it is.
All right, well, we're going to find out right now. Lisa, you said that you think A is yours. Jeff, which one was yours? A, you got it. All right. All right, Drisana, which one of these is you?
B.
You think it's B?
Yeah.
Let's see what he said. He said, yeah, it's B. All right. What is that?
Oh, my goodness. Oh, I can't believe this.
Let me draw a little hair up here on the neck.
That's so wild. It's okay.
Huh. I'll be darned. Okay, Tammy, you said that D is yours. He said... It's C. C is you.
Oh, you were being nice, honey.
Of course I was.
I think that's being nice,
Thank
huh?
Thank you.
Okay. And April, you say that D is you. He said D is you. All right. Okay. We'll be back to see how well the wives can predict what their husbands will say right after these messages. newlywed game. All right, now, ladies, your husbands are all secluded off stage, and we're going to have some fun while they're gone, because these are the 10-point questions. You ready for one? Here we go. Ladies, what part of your husband's body will he say could pass for a woman's? What part of his body could pass for a woman's? Lisa?
Oh, his legs. He's got the thinnest, skinniest legs.
Little skinny legs.
Skinny.
No, I wonder if they got hair on them like Tammy's.
Like a rug.
Like a rug, okay. Good. April.
The legs. My husband's got little chicken legs and not much hair. And it's just a little bit of hair.
He doesn't have any hair on his legs?
His little chicken legs.
Little chicken legs. No kidding.
They look just like his sister's.
His sister's got chicken legs too, huh?
Yeah,
the whole family's got chicken legs, huh? Tammy.
I would have to say his stomach. When I was pregnant, we'd stick our stomachs out, and we both matched. And now
really?
I'm kind of losing mine, and he still kind of has his.
Stomach like a woman,
stomach,
all right?
Yeah.
Drusana?
I would have to say legs as well.
He's got legs like a
bird
girl.
Bird legs.
Bony?
Bony.
Bird legs.
Bird legs.
Bird legs.
Bird legs.
Yeah, okay. Next question, ladies. If we were to average out the amount of times all our newlywed couples have sex, will your husband say you two fall above the average or below the average? April?
Probably below the average.
Sorry.
We're a little slow on the start these days.
Well, in astronaut terms, never mind. Tammy?
Way below.
Way below.
We have two kids, and he works, and he goes to bed early. I go to bed late, and we can never find time.
Well, you got two kids, so something must have happened sometime. Drusana?
Way below. Yeah.
What's the problem? Tell Dr. Bob.
Me.
What is it?
Raymond, he's good to go, but
yeah.
Every 3 days, but he wants it every day.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Wow. Every day.
Huh. So you're calling every 3 days way below average.
I think so.
Yeah. Talk to Tammy down here. She's laughing up a storm. Lisa.
Below. We have a new baby and a 4-year-old.
Way below. Okay,
below.
Next question, ladies. How will your husband say you would complete this sentence? This is you talking. The way my husband drives, we really should have a little sign on the car window that reads, warning, blank on board. The way he drives, Tammy. Warning, blank on board.
Today on the way up here, idiot on board.
Idiot on board.
Yes.
Drusana.
Yes.
Slow poke.
Slow poke on board.
Yeah.
Lisa.
Man.
Man?
Man on board.
Man on board.
Yeah.
April.
Speed demon.
Speed demon on board.
We have a truck and he flies like it's a little tiny car.
Well, he's got little bony legs, that's why. Next question, ladies. Exactly how many pillows will your husband say there are currently on your bed? Drusana?
Four.
There's four of them. Lisa?
Six.
Six. April?
Three.
Three, Tammy?
We only have two, and he sleeps with both of them.
Okay, thank you. We'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the newlywed game right after these messages.
The Buzzer Academy of Hosting presents Tossing to Commercial.
We'll be back.
We'll be back first.
This.
Keep it right here on Buzzer.
newlywed game. Everybody's got 5 points except for couple number four. They're 5 points ahead right now. But we'll see what happens. Gentlemen, let's see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. And remember, these questions will now be worth 10 points. And here is your first one. Gentlemen, what part of your body would you say could pass for a woman's? What part of your body, John, could pass for a woman's?
Well, I'm going to have to say she's going to probably pick my legs.
How come?
She always complains that, like, my legs sometimes are, like, too slender, and then she gets a little jealous, I think.
You mean? What are you telling me? She's got fat legs?
No, it's just, it's a little pudgy. And then...
Oh, she's got... Pudgy legs. I see.
Not that bad.
All right, so she predicted that you would say, your legs, yeah, that's right. In fact, John, she said you have chicken legs, and so is your sister.
Did she?
In fact, she said the whole family's got chicken legs.
How did you say that? Huh. Because I raised the chickens in the backyard.
She's going to say my legs.
Your legs.
Yeah, I got skinny legs.
Skinny legs, yeah. So does April's family. Oh, John's family. Somebody. Let me see what she says. She said, yeah, it's your legs. You got skinny legs. Yeah. Raymond.
I'm going to go with legs.
Legs, all right. She said that you have legs like a girl. Yeah. All right, Louis.
I'm going to have to say my legs.
Your legs?
Yeah, let's say, yeah. Because my legs are pretty, they're pretty
they're
nice.
They're pretty hairy like mine.
Your legs are pretty nice, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, they're not very hairy like regular man's legs. You know,
oh, you're not a regular man?
I am a regular man.
Yeah, well, you still don't have legs like a regular man. She said, no, it's your stomach is like a girl's.
Oh.
Yeah.
How did you figure that?
When I was pregnant, and we were sticking our bellies out, and we matched. Well, but I don't anymore, and you do.
Why?
Go ahead.
Next question, gentlemen. If we were to average out the amount of times all newlywed couples have sex, would you say you and your wife fall above the average or below the average? Jeff, if we're going to average out all newlyweds, the times they have sex, would you guys be above or below the average?
Oh, below the average.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we got kids, yeah, below the average.
Yeah, not as sorry as you are, but I'm sorry. Yeah. All right, she said definitely you would be below the average. Yeah. Raymond.
Below.
Below?
Well, below.
Are you complaining, Raymond?
I'm complaining.
You
upset.
Are. On national television, mad. You're complaining.
I'm a little upset, Bob.
Well, tell her about it.
Need a little bit more activity.
Rosanna says way below the average. Yeah. What do you think, Louis?
I'm going to have to say below the average.
Below the average.
Yep.
All right. Below the average, what she said. Let's check out Mr. Romance. John, what do you think?
Well, I sympathize with all the other guys. I'm going to have to say below the average.
Below the average. Yep. Great sympathy there. Okay, she said below the average. Okay. Next question, gentlemen. How would your wife complete this sentence? This is her talking. The way my husband drives, we really should have a little sign on the car window that reads, warning, blank on board. The way you drive? Raymond, you should have a sign that says blank on board.
Idiot on board.
Idiot.
I would never say that on TV.
A wife would.
I would never call you an idiot.
No.
What do you say?
No. Slow poke.
Oh, slow.
Wife would never say idiot on board.
I would
on
never
TV.
Call you an idiot on TV.
Absolutely not. Louis.
At home.
I'm sorry that you had to hear that, by the way.
Well, I'm gonna have to say speedster.
Speedster. You know what she said? She said idiot on board. My goodness. What do you think here, John?
I think speed racer.
Speed racer. She said the big old sign that said speed demon. Okay, Judge? Sure, Judge. Jeff.
It's going to be something with lost in it. I'm always lost.
Lost on board. All right. She predicted you would say man on board. All right, before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Kramer.
You're going to Barbados.
Almond Beach Resorts in Barbados. Stay at the intimate club or the larger village and enjoy privileges in both locations. Luxury rooms, gourmet dining, water sports, and nightly entertainment. Almond Beach Resorts, Barbados. Back to you, Bob.
Thank you, John, very much. 25-point bonus question. Somebody's going to Barbados. Gentlemen, exactly how many pillows are currently on your bed? How many pillows are currently on your bed? Couple one, Louie and Tammy with 15. 25 gives you 40. Get it right, and you're going to be in first place, Louie.
Two.
She said, hey, two. You got it. You're in first place. Couple number three, Jeff and Lisa Hurd. You have 25. 25 gives you 50. Take over the lead with the correct answer, Jeff.
Five.
She said there's a grand total of six. You missed one. Couple number four, Raymond and Drisana. You have 30. 25 gives you 55. Get it right. You're in the lead, Raymond.
Four.
She said there's four. You got it.
Yes.
All right, couple number two, John and April with 35. 25 gives you a grand total of 60 points. If you get it right, you're on your way for a second honeymoon. John?
Three.
She said? Three. You got it. John and April, you're our Newlywed Game grand prize winners. Hey, thanks to all of our couples. Most of all, thanks to you. I'm Bob Eubanks, and we will see you again. Bye-bye, everybody.